Hey guys, I got these two new products. So let's open them up quickly and look what is inside. Now, here what you see are two beautiful power supplies. They are quite long without any cooling fan, which means they are silent operating. Now, the label says 110 volts to 220 volts input and a DC output of 12 volts and 20 amperes. So let's test them quickly. AC input, DC output. Positive, negative. Connecting the AC input side, 220 volts. Turning it on. As you can see that it is working and the bulb is glowing quite bright. The output voltage is 12.33 volts. Moving on to the current testing part, I have this DC motor, high current 12 volts. So let's turn on the supply and test the amperes. Let's see the starting amperes. It was peaking at 5. Once again, 6.65. Now for maximum ampere test, I'm using this e-bike motor, 24 volts and 27 amperes. Let's see the current rating now. 5 amperes, 9 amperes. So as always, the high current bike starter motor, 17 amperes, 20, whoa, once again, whoa, 50 amperes, once again, so this power supply is rated at 20 amperes and with a maximum peak of 50 amps and stabilizing at 20. So it's working great. And this completes the high current testing. Let's move on further. Now I have two identical power supplies, which means that I can connect them in series. So starting with the 12 volts output side, take two wires with a tapping point here and connect them to the positive output terminals of one power supply as shown. Next, take another piece and connect it to the negative of the other power supply. After that, take two jumper wires and connect them as shown. And thus completing the connections for the output side. Moving on to the input 220 volts side. Now take the 220 volts AC wire and two jumper wires and couple them as shown. And now that we have done all the connections, let's test it. So the new output voltage is 24.65 and the current is still the same, 20 amperes. So let's try this DC motor now. Oh, very high starting torque. That's really difficult to hold it strongly. Now, in one of my previous videos, I made this 24 volts, 20 amperes backup power supply for my 3D printer. But this power supply got damaged, so I'm going to replace it with our new one. So, checking our old power supply. This is green indicator light. Turning it on, it's not glowing. Removing cable for safety. Thank you. Now, the first thing to check in a dead power supply is its fuse. So here I'm going to do it with the traditional method. Take two jumper cables, connect one to one side of the fuse and other to the other side of the fuse, the metallic part. Next, take a 100 watts bulb and connect the ends of the wires to the bulb like this. Now I'm going to turn on the power supply and see if this green LED glows this time. Oops. Now, because the bulb is glowing really bright, it means that there is some major fault with the circuit, because of which it is drawing way too much starting current. Now the circuit components look fine, so we will have to check them manually. So for the AC input side, we have the fuse, NTC, capacitor, resistor, rectifier, this 1:1 transformer, and again this red capacitor, and so on. Now the capacitors are okay because otherwise they get inflated. Next, transformer and resistors rarely go bad. Continuity mode, NTC check. It's fine. Fuse, it's dead. Open. A resistor, 1.1 ohm. So the fault is somewhere here, because this resistor is 680 kilo ohms and it is showing only 1.1 ohm for this color band. And finally, the rectifier, this one. Seems like the rectifier is short. Now, to desolder this rectifier, it is a little difficult to keep the PCB like this, you see. Therefore, I have designed this 3D print, link for which will be provided in the description. Okay, you see. So this way I can keep the circuit board stable in one place and of multiple sizes. As you can see, the design is quite robust and keeps the circuit board held strongly in one place. And there is enough gap between the components and the base for most circuits. So checking the rectifier once again, it's fine. It is fine, not short, which means the problem might be on the DC side. So starting with these two transistors. So here I've removed both the high voltage switching transistors. 2SC2625 and the high speed rectifier D9202. As you can see, all the three components are completely short. Now, just for finding out if the rest of the circuit is fine, I'm going to replace these with these two small 13009 transistors and this high speed rectifier. And now that the soldering part is fully complete, it is time to test it. So here I'm going to start the circuit. Let's see if this green light glows this time. Okay, go. Okay, go. The fuse is dead. So there are some major faults with the circuit, and these were not the only ones. So finishing off the video now and coming with proper repairing in the future. Bye bye.